Assalamu alaikum friends, my name is Muhammad Yunus and I am Udoo Technical Developer. In this video, we are going to talk about how to add a warning message on printing a report on the basis of some condition. So you can say like, you can add a condition like you raise a warning message for certain amount of people. So you can do this by adding a security group. So if the user has the access of that security group, then it should allow to print the report. Otherwise, it should raise a warning message. So for example, let me show you a demo that what we are going to do in this video. So for example, if you go to the sessions and then open any session, for example this one, and this session has no attendees. So we want to raise a warning message that if there is no attendees, then don't print the report. So for example, let me just click the print button, and here you can see there is no attendees for the session Udoo Technical Seminar 1-1. So this kind of warning message we can add on the basis of the security group. We can add on the basis of the states. So whatever condition you add in the Python method, in this video we are just going to talk about this. So for this purpose, we have to find out the external ID of this report. In order to do so, first of all, activate the debug mode and then go to settings and then technical and then click on the reports. So here you will have to hit this name, search with this name, session report like this, and then enter. So this is the report that we are looking for, and this is the external ID. So for this template, this is actually the template ID of this QWeb report, and here we need to check first that whether the get report method is defined for this report already or not. So for this purpose, you will have to search inside the module, and then you will have to choose the file mask is Python. So you will have to search it inside the Python. So as you already know that this get report values method is not defined for this report, so we will have to define it. So for this purpose, let me just add init file here, and then we will have to add a py file session report, and here we will have to import the models fields from Udoo, import model fields API and underscore, and here we will have to import user error also, and we need to define the class. You can add the name here, session report, and the class should be abstract, and then define the name. So the name has a special format. So for this purpose, first of all, you will have to add the name of the module. Then, first of all, you will have to add report keyword, and then the name of the module, and then the external ID of the template. So this is it. And then we will have to add the method. So the method name is define. So here we will have to search inside the addons, define get report values like this, self values, so like this. So let me just search some method which is just a simple one. So let me just copy it here and then paste it here. So this is the model, this is the method that we need to define for adding a warning message, or you can just make some you can pass some other values into the report. So dark IDs is actually like, for example, if I click on this printer, so this record ID is passed as dark IDs and data will be passed as some context value and some form values. So here our dark IDs in this case will be this session, and so for this purpose we will have to find the records of all the sessions. So sessions is equal to self.env, and here we will need to add the model name, which is you can take from here, like this is the report and the report model is this one. So copy and paste from here and then browse and then add doc IDs like this, and here change the model to openacademy.session, and here we will have to change it to openacademy.session. So remove this report type, we don't need it. So what we need to do, we have to loop through each session and check if any session contain empty attendees, like any session that is we are going to print and the session does not contain any attendees, so we will have to raise a warning message for that. So for this purpose we will have to add a loop for session in sessions, and here we will have to check if length of session dot attendee IDs is equal to zero, then raise user error that for example here we will make it formattable, and here we will add the session name, session dot display name have no attendees like this. So now restart Odoo service and then let me print the report. So for example, so first of all this user don't have access, so let me just give the access of the manager. So go here and then give the access, and then let me refresh this page and let me open any session. So this session does not contain any attendee, so let me just print this report. So here you should get a warning message like this session does not contain any attendees, so it has been printed, so there is some issue. So is we have just added the Python file, but we have not imported it inside the init. So we will have to import it inside the init session report, and then we will have to import this reports directory inside this init. So from dot import reports like this. So I hope so that this time it will work. So let me just change the name and then let me print it again. So click the session report, and here we got an error message that Odoo technical seminar have no attendees. So this type of warnings we can add on the basis of the states, we can also add on the basis of the security groups and so on. So you can add any kind of condition if you know little bit about Python. And let me show you that how you can add on the basis of the security group. So for example, we want to raise a warning message if someone don't have access of the Open Academy manager. So let me just change this name, and then we will have to add the code for this purpose. So let me comment this code, and then here we will have to get the current user. For example, if self.env.user, this will give us the user that is going to print the report, and here we will have to call a method hasGroup. hasGroup means that if this person have access to this group. So which group we are talking about is the Open Academy Manager. So we will have to add here, and then first we will have to add the module name and then dot, and then so we need to add a condition like if someone don't have access to this group, so we will have to add not at the start of this condition, then raise a warning message like you do not have access to print this report, so like this. So let me just restart this auto service and then click this session report. So you will get a warning message that you don't have access to print this report. So so actually we could able to print this report because we have not removed this access, right? So let me just change the name and then remove this access, right? And then we will see. So click this session report, and here you can see you don't have access to print this report. So the same way we can add on the basis of the state. So for example, if we add on the basis of the state, like if the state of this course is a draft, then raise a warning message that you cannot print this report because the course of this session is in draft state. So you can add whatever condition you want, and this method is used to pass some custom data to the report. So whatever you add here, like doc IDs, it will be passed to the report. And let me open this report. So these docs contain these docs we sent it here. So this is passed like this one. So whatever we pass here, it will be printed on the report. So thank you guys for watching this video. If you have enjoyed this video, please give a huge thumbs up, and also please subscribe to our channel. And if you want to get the updates of the upcoming videos, so please don't forget to click the bell icon so that you can get the updates of the upcoming videos. Thank you.